Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to talk about how to detect a cycle in a directed graph. In another video, I talked about how to detect a cycle in undirected graph. Today we're going to talk about directed graph. So the idea is to use a depth first search. While doing a depth first search, we're going to maintain three sets, a white set, a gray set, and a black set. White set has all the vertices which has not been visited at all. Gray set has all the vertices which are being visited right now. And black set has all the vertices which have totally been visited, meaning that all its children have also been visited. So while doing this depth first search, if we encounter a vertex in a gray set, it means that we found a cycle. Why? Because when a vertex is in a gray set, it means that its neighbors or neighbors' neighbors or somebody in that hierarchy is still being explored, and that vertex found a path back to the vertex in a gray set, indicating that there is a presence of a cycle. So next, let's try to apply this algorithm on this graph here. So first thing we do is we put all the vertices in this white set here. Then we are going to continue to do depth first search till either we find a cycle in this graph or we have moved all the vertices from white set to black set. If all the vertices have been moved to black set, it means that there is no cycle in this graph. So let's start from any random vertex. So let's say we start from vertex 1. So first thing we do is we move this vertex to gray set. And also in this DFS map, I'm going to indicate that 1 got introduced by null because there is no parent of 1 because 1 is the start point. Then we are going to explore neighbors of 1. So one neighbor of 1 is 2. 2 is not there in the black set. 2 is not there in the gray set, but 2 is in the white set. So then we are going to take 2 out of the white set and then add it into the gray set because now we're going to explore 2 and also indicate here that 2 got introduced by 1. So now we're going to explore neighbors of 2. One neighbor of 2 is 3. 3 is not in the black set, it means that it's not visited. 3 is not in the gray set, so there is no cycle yet. But 3 is in the white set. So again, we're going to move 3 from white set to gray set. Indicate that 3 got introduced by 2 and explore neighbors of 3. 3 has no more neighbors. It means that 3 is totally explored, which means that we can move 3 from gray set to black set. Remember, black set has all the vertices which are totally visited. Now we are going to go back from 3 to 2 and explore other neighbors of 2, but 2 has no more neighbors to be explored. So we are going to move 2 from gray set to black set and go back to 1. 1 has one more neighbor, 3, to be explored. But 3 is already in the black set. It means that there is no reason to visit 3 again. So 1 doesn't visit 3. And at this point, 1 has no more neighbors to be explored. So we'll move 1 to black set. Now, at this point, we are done doing the DFS starting with 1. So we are going to go back to the white set and see that white set is still not empty. So pick another random vertex in the white set. So let's say we picked 4 and now we're going to do our DFS around 4. So we are going to move 4 from white set to gray set. So now we're going to explore neighbors of 4. So first we're going to say that 4 got introduced by null because in DFS 4 doesn't have a parent. So one neighbor of 4 is 1. But 1 is already in the black set, so we are not going to explore 1 again. So we are going to explore other neighbor of 4. So another neighbor of 4 is 5. So 5 is not in the black set, 5 is not in the gray set, but 5 is in the white set. So again, we are going to move 5 to gray set because now we are going to explore 5. And here I am going to say that 5 got introduced by 4. Now, one neighbor of 5 is 6. 6 is not in black set, 6 is not in gray set, 6 is in white set. So we're going to move from 6 from white set to gray set and say that 6 got introduced by 5. And now we're going to explore neighbors of 6. One neighbor of 6 is 4. 4 is not in the black set, but 4 is in a gray set. It means that we found a cycle in this graph. So to figure out that what is that cycle, we can retrace our steps back. So we know that 6 found 4, so edge 6, 4 is in the cycle. Then we go to 6 and see who introduced 6. So 6 got introduced by 5, so edge 5, 6 is in the cycle. And then we're going to check who introduced 5, and 5 was introduced by 4, So edge 4, 5 is in a cycle, and 4 is the point at which we stopped. So this here is indicating our cycle. 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and 6 back to 4. So now for suppose that we did not have this edge 6, 4. If we did not have this edge 6, 4, in that case, what would happen was that 6 would have no more neighbors to be explored, so we would move 6 here. And then 5 would have no more neighbors to be explored, so we move 5 to black set. And then 4 would have no more neighbors to be explored, so we would move 4 to black set. And in that case, we would not find any cycle. So if this edge 6 to 4 does not exist, this graph should return false because there is no cycle. And if this edge 6, 4 exists, then this graph has a cycle and it should return true. The time complexity for this algorithm is O of E plus V, and the space complexity is O of V. So next, let's look at the code for this algorithm.
The main function here is hasCycle it takes in the graph. First thing we do is we initialize white set, gray set, and black set. Then we are going to add all the vertices to white set. So white set here has all the 5 vertices. Then while the white set size is greater than 0, it is greater than 0, we are going to take any random vertex from the white set. So let's say we got 1. So in DFS, now we are going to go into DFS with current as 1 and passing white set, gray set, and black set. So in the DFS, first thing we do is we move the current, which is 1, from white set to gray set, because now we are going to explore 1. We're going to get neighbors of 1. So one neighbor of 1 is 2. So 2 is not in the black set. So first thing we check is 2 in the black set? It's not, which means that 2 can be explored. 2 is not in the gray set, which means that we haven't found a cycle yet. Then we're going to go into the DFS and check and explore 2. So again, we go into the recursion, this time with value neighbor, and neighbor is 2. So we come back to the top here. So first thing again we do is we move 2 from white set to gray set. Then we're going to explore neighbors of 2. So 2 has no neighbors. So what we're going to do is we are done exploring 2. So we're going to move 2 from gray set to black set. So 2 moves to black set, and then we're going to return false. So when we go back in recursion, we reach to the point here where we went to the recursion to the 2, and now the current is 1. So if DFS, so since we got false from 2, it means that there is no cycle with 2 involved. So we are going to go back to the top of the for loop, and again current here is 1, and now 1 has no more neighbors to be explored. So we come out of the for loop, and we're going to move 1 from gray set to black set, and 1 is also going to return false. So this returns false to this DFS here. So again, since this is false, we don't go into this if condition, and then we're going to go back to the top of this while loop. Now the while white set still has 3 more elements to go. So again, we're going to randomly pick another element. Let's say we picked 4. So then our current becomes 4, and we're again going to go into the DFS with 4 and see if we can find cycle with 4 as a starting point. So here, first thing we do is we move 4 from white set to gray set. So here, 4 moved from white to gray, and then we're going to explore neighbors of 4. One neighbor of 4 is 1. So we come to this if condition, but 1 is already in a black set, so we do nothing about 1 and continue and look for another neighbor. So another neighbor of 4 is 5. 5 is not there in the black set. 5 is not there in the gray set. So now we're going to explore 5. And to do that, we go into the DFS. So now our current is 5. So first thing we do is move 5 from white set to gray set. So this is what happens. And then now we're going to explore neighbors of 5. So one neighbor of 5 is 6. And 6 is not in black set. 6 is not in gray set. So again, we're going to do a DFS with 6 as the current. So we go back to the top of this function. First thing we do is we move 6 from white set to gray set. So that's what happens here. And now we're going to explore neighbors of 6. So one neighbor of 6 is 4. So 4 is not in a black set, but 4 is in a gray set. 4 here is in a gray set, which means that we found a cycle because 4 was being explored. So this returns true immediately. So what this means is it returns true, so 6 returns true to its calling function, and 6 was called from 5. So 5, we return to the point here, and this is true. So 5 returns true to its calling function, and 5 was called from 4. So we come to this point where current is 4, and this, since this is true, so 4 returns true to its calling function, which was here. So we come to this point, and since this is true, this returns true. So since this graph has a cycle, it returns true, saying that this has cycle. So this is all I have to talk about this algorithm. To link to this code and to both Java code and Python code is in the description section of the video. Please like this video, comment on this video, check out my Facebook page, and check out my GitHub link. Thanks again for watching this video.